Hi friends, welcome to today's class. Today's question is, a financier claims to be lending money at simple interest, but he includes the interest every 6 months for calculating the principal. If he is charging an interest rate of 10%, determine the effective rate of interest. So what's the given question? A financier is telling that he is lending the money at simple interest. So normally simple interest we will be calculating for 1 year. But here what he is doing? He is actually calculating simple interest at the end of 6 months. At the end of first 6 months itself, he is calculating this simple interest and he will be adding it to the principal. Okay. So suppose P is the principal at the beginning of the year. So after 6 months, let the interest is equal to I1. So the new principal at the beginning of 6th month, okay, at the beginning of 7th month, at the beginning of 7th month, the new principal will be P plus I1. And for this P plus I1 only, he will be going to charge the remaining interest. Again, he will be charging the interest rate for the new principal, P plus I1. So, we have to find out the effective rate of interest. As we solve this, we will be able to understand more. So, we have to find out the rate of interest as a percentage only. Okay, rate of interest is always given as a percentage. Rate of interest is always expressed as a percentage. So, what you have to do? We can assume that sum is equal to 100. So, it will be easy to determine. So, once you get the rate of interest, you can directly write it as a percentage. So, that is the reason why we are taking sum is equal to 100. So, here in order to find out the effective rate of interest, we have to find out the rate of interest for the entire year. Okay. So, for first 6 months, what is the rate of interest? That we can first find out. For the first 6 months, sum is equal to 100. So, P is 100. Okay. So, for the first 6 months, the simple interest will be equal to 100 into 10 into, 10 is the rate of interest. 10 into time. Time is equal to 1 by 2. Okay, 6 months. So 6 divided by 12 will be giving it as half year. We have to write time as year. So, it will be 1 by 2. So, PRT divided by 100. So, our answer will be 5. So for the first 6 months, simple interest is equal to rupees 5. So, what is the new principal? New principal for the next 6 months. We have to calculate the simple interest for the next 6 months. For the next 6 months, the principal will be equal to 100 plus 5 is equal to 105. That is the new principal. So, simple interest for the next 6 months will be equal to 105 into, it will be 105 into 10 into half divided by 100. So, what you will be getting? So, here this 0 and this 0 is getting cancelled. So, it will be 105 by 20, which will be giving it as rupees 5.25. So, we are obtaining 5 rupees for the first 6 months and 5.25 rupees for the next 6 months. Rupees 5 for the first 6 months and rupees 5.25 for the next 6 months. The total interest will be the sum of these two interest. Because we have calculated it for a sum of 100, we can write it as our final answer. Okay, we have taken sum is equal to 100 or P is equal to 100. So, our interest will be equal to 5 plus 5.25, which is equal to 10.25. It is 10.25% per annum. So, we are calculating the simple interest for the first 6 months. Then, we are calculating the simple interest for the next 6 months. And we have calculated this on the sum is equal to 100. So, we will be getting the answer directly. So, let's see one more example to make the concept clear. A financier claims to be lending money at simple interest, but he includes the interest every 6 months for calculating the principal. If he is charging an interest rate of 8%, determine the effective rate of interest. So, here also we have to find out the rate of interest. Always rate of interest is expressed in percentage. So, we are taking P is equal to rupees 100. And we have to find out the simple interest for the first 6 months. And then we have to find out the simple interest for the next 6 months by changing the principal. For the first 6 months, simple interest will be equal to, simple interest is equal to PRT by 100. So, P is equal to 100. 100 into R is equal to 8. And time we have to express it as an year. So, 6 months will be 6 by 12 is equal to half year. Half, but 100 will come. So, we will be getting rupees 4. So, rupees 4 is the simple interest for first 6 months. So, the new principal for the next 6 months will be equal to 100 plus 4 is equal to 104. So 104 is the principal for the next 6 months. Then we'll be having the simple interest for the next 6 months. Okay, first 6 months we already found out the simple interest. Now simple interest for the next 6 months will be equal to new principal is 104. So 104 into 8 into half and 100. Yeah. So what we'll be getting? So it will be equal to rupees 4.16. So that will be your simple interest. By solving this, we'll be getting rupees 4.16. So our total interest will be equal to the simple interest for the first 6 months plus the simple interest for the last 6 months. So it will be rupees 8.16. So it will be 8.16% per annum. We can write this directly because we have calculated it on the sum of rupees 100. Thank you for watching.